Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kevin Lorenz, and I am the Associate AD for Communications here at Rutgers. I'd like to welcome everyone to today's press conference to announce our new head coach, men's basketball, Steve Pikiell. Today is a very special day at Rutgers. Before I go over today's format, I would like to send a special thank you to our good friends at BTN. Today's press conference is being broadcast live to more than 60 million homes across the United States and Canada. We are very appreciative of this opportunity. We are joined today by Rutgers President Dr. Robert Barchi, Director of Athletics Pat Hobbs, and next head coach Steve Pikiell. We will begin the press conference with opening remarks from Dr. Barchi, Mr. Hobbs, followed by remarks from Coach Pikiell. We will then open the floor for questions. If you wish to ask a question, please raise your hand and wait for one of the two microphones in the audience. Jimmy and Steph have those microphones. Please identify yourself by name and affiliation before directing your question. Following the Q&A session, we will have a brief photo op with President Barchi, Mr. Hobbs, and Coach Pikiell before breaking off into one-on-one sessions with Mr. Hobbs and Coach Pikiell. Please welcome Rutgers University President, Dr. Robert Barchi.
Thanks very much. I am really, really happy to be here today, and I'm delighted to see so many of you here to join us in welcoming Steve here as our new head coach. I have to tell you, I'm not going to say anything about him, because that's Pat's job. I just want to say a few things about how we got to this point. If we go back 3 months ago, in the last 3 months, we've really pretty much taken a new look at sports here at Rutgers. We're hiring Pat Hobbs is our AD, hiring a new head football coach, and finishing the trifecta today with a new basketball coach. And I couldn't be more delighted. I have to say that the hiring of the basketball coach is 100% the job of the AD. It's his expertise that made this happen and his hard work in the several past weeks that have gotten us to this point. All I did was to lay down a few requirements. What did I want to see in a head football coach, a head basketball coach here? Some of the same things that I asked him to bring us in a head football coach. I wanted to see an individual who was going to build a winning program and who had the experience and the track record of having done that. And here we have someone who's done that since the time he was a college player in every location that he's been involved. I wanted someone that was going to come and build an ethical program, a program that no one could ever question. Anything happening that was outside the norm, whether it's the NCAA or the Big Ten or the university board or any of us, that we'd all be proud of the program that we have here. And I'm convinced that the individual who's taken over the helm has that depth of ethical quality in his coaching that'll make us all proud. And the third thing that I wanted was someone that had the same passion about the academic side of development of his team as he does as the athletic side of development. That's a big, big issue for me. It's a big issue for Rutgers. And I'm delighted to see that Steve has been able to take, in his last position, a team that was among the lowest in their academic performance and progress rating to one that's been in the top 10 in the last 2 years running. That's what we want to see here. We want to see winning teams, we want to see athletes who are successful in the court, and we want to see young men and women who are successful in life afterwards. So I'm going to just let it go at that and turn it over to our athletic director, Pat Hobbs, to tell you about the individual who met all these criteria and is going to take Rutgers basketball to the next level. Pat?
Thank you, Pat. Thank you, Dr. Barchi. I want to welcome everyone here on what is a very special day for Rutgers University, a special day for Rutgers Athletics, where we welcome our new men's basketball head coach, Steve Pikiell, to his professional home. That's why we're here. That's why we're in your professional home. Coach's wife, Kate, couldn't be with us, but she's watching on BTN. So I say to you, Kate, we look forward to welcoming you here at Rutgers. It's a great day for you, I know, and we'll see you here very, very soon, and we'll all be cheering very loudly as Steve begins a great, great run here at Rutgers University. But we've got Steve's four children here, Brooke and John and Kevin and Olivia. Welcome. They got the red ties, and I see they're trying, they've got a little bit of red there already, so they're ready for their RU days. We're very excited to have them here. I also want to say a thank you and a welcome. The America East Commissioner, Amy Hutchhausen, is here to congratulate Coach Pikiell, and so welcome. A few quick thank yous. We were assisted in this search by Bodine Eastman, so I do want to say to Bob Bodine and Kevin Gall, thank you for all of your help. They helped us with our previous search in men's football. Tremendous, tremendous assist. I do want to thank also from my staff three people who helped me throughout the process, Ryan Passari, Sarah Baumgartner, and Janine Picaro. I seem to always ruin weekends for Janine, so I owe you a few, Janine. I do also want to say thank you to all of the coaches who participated throughout the process. One of the things that has just impressed me is just how fortunate we are today in intercollegiate athletics to have some of the leadership out there that we have today. And it's a testament to Steve Pikiell that he rose to the top in this search, because there's really some tremendous individuals who care deeply about our student athletes, care about the college experience. And so I want to thank all of them who participated in the process. One of the things I say is that in every search, you want that moment. You want that moment where you know you are sitting across the table from that person. That person who, they're talking, and you just have that feeling that starts to well up where you say, this is the person. This is the right fit. This is the person who I want to lead our student athletes. This is the person who I want going out on behalf of Rutgers University and recruiting student athletes. This is the person that we want to be the ambassador for Rutgers University, not just as our head men's basketball coach, but as a representative of who we are here at Rutgers University. 3 months ago, I found that person in Chris Ash. And on Saturday morning, sitting in New York City, I found that person in Steve Pikiell. Tremendous, tremendous human being. You know, Jerry Carino asked me at the beginning of this search, he said, Pat, what are your ingredients? What are you searching for in a basketball head coach? And I said, I'll tell you what I'm going to search for in every coach here at Rutgers University. I need somebody of character. I need somebody with integrity. I need somebody with intensity. I need somebody with commitment. And I need somebody with a plan. And that is illustrated by person I hired 3 months ago, and the person who sits here up on the dais today, Steve Pikiell. Now, our university is a special university. Now, those of us who either grew up in New Jersey or have watched Rutgers University know that we are a gateway university. We're a great academic institution, but nearly 500,000 people have come to Rutgers University in the desire to have success in life, and they've had great success. They've had financial success. Many of them have changed the way we live. They are strivers. They strive for grace and greatness, and they strive for excellence. And Steve Pikiell is a striver. He is somebody who grew up with very modest roots. He's one of nine children. He's got some of his family, his brothers are here today. He's got sisters and other brothers who are watching on BTN up and down the Eastern Seaboard. Nothing was handed to him at any time in his life. And as Dr. Barchi said, at every stage of his life, he's achieved success. And one of the ways you could describe Steve Pikiell is he has arrived at every program at its low, and he has left every program at its height. Worst to first, that's Steve Pikiell. He did it as a student. He was Jim Calhoun's first recruit at the University of Connecticut when they were dead bottom in the Big East. And by the time he was finished and he was a co-captain, they competed for the Big East championship and they were in the NCAA tournament. And we know what happened to UConn in the years following that. After that, assistant coach at UConn, and then he went on and was assistant coach at Central Connecticut State and at GW. What did he do there? Again, arrived when those programs were at the bottom, spearheaded recruiting, brought those programs, and by the time he left those programs, they were both conference champions. And then a little university called Stony Brook approached him about taking over their program. And he was told, it's a bad job, don't take over that job. They just moved from D3 to D1. They were the doormat of the conference, and folks were saying, you'll get a better job, just wait. And he said, no, that's where I want to be. I want to go and I want to build something. And he went to Stony Brook, and sure, in those first couple of years they struggled, in part because their APR was the lowest in the nation. Right? We're not talking about 920, 910, we're talking down around 800. All right? You know what that means, those of you who are in coaching. And all he did then was fix that, and then in the last five years, all right, they have been at the top of the conference. They've won 70% of their overall games, and they've won 84% of their conference games, and they've been in the top 10 in the country in APR. So that says something about the individual that is Steve Pikiell and what he brings here to Rutgers University today. Character, integrity, intensity, commitment, and a plan. Please join me in welcoming our new men's head basketball coach, Steve Pikiell.
It's always a good sign when your head coach has to tilt the mic up high. It means I'm at that size. I am so honored, you know, to be here today. And I want to thank everyone here for coming out to support. I'm excited about the band. I've been excited. I don't think I've slept in 4 days. This has been quite a whirlwind for me. But this has always been a dream job for me. And I drove up and down the New Jersey Turnpike for years, recruiting at George Washington University, at Yale University, at Central Connecticut State University, at UConn, and most recently at Stony Brook University. And I would drive by that sign, and I'd say, that's the job I want. And I'm humble, and I'm very appreciative, and I'm very thankful for this opportunity. President Barchi, I thank you for trusting me with your program. The best recruiter, I think, in our athletic department is Pat Hobbs. And I was trying to recruit him during this process, and he in turn got me so excited about this job, told him I would walk down the New Jersey Turnpike for an opportunity. And that's all I've ever asked for, is an opportunity. And for that, I'm very thankful. And I told him every job along the way, I've never let an athletic director down, I've never let a president down, and I've never let a student body down. And I am not going to do it here at Rutgers. I embrace challenges. I'm one of nine brothers and sisters. Those challenges started at the dinner table, some of them, and went throughout my life. But I've earned everything, you know, that I've gotten, and I'm real proud of the programs that I've been a part of, and a lot of help from a lot of people in order to build a program. And I'm thankful that you're here today, and we're going to need your help. We're going to need the student athletes, the guys who I met yesterday and told them that we want to dance here. That's our goal, is to dance, and they like to dance. But I want to dance on the court, not in the nightclub, right, Shaq? Yeah, that's what we would like to do. And I challenged them to embrace the challenge. This university has all the ingredients to be great. It's a great state. It's a great university. The greatest conference in the country. And what I've found in a short period of time is great people. I had a wonderful job at Stony Brook, and I had those ingredients there, and the great people, and a great university, and I left that. I had other opportunities, and I never liked any of the other. I didn't think they had those ingredients, and I'm fortunate enough, Pat did his homework, and I told him, the more you talk to people, and the more you ask questions, the more you're going to like me. And To his credit, I think he did his homework. I am going to work diligently here. I'm going to do it the right way. We're going to build a program that everybody can be proud of. We're going to work in recruiting. I'm a morning guy, a lot of coffee, and a lot of energy. And I've embraced this challenge the same way I embraced the challenge at all the universities that I've been a part of. And I am up for the challenge. There's some people here in the audience that, you know, I want to introduce, really people that have been special in my life. I have my staff from Stony Brook University who worked by my side diligently, some of the greatest guys going, Coach Young, Coach Dan, Brian Dewar, Coach Chapman. I want to thank Stony Brook University for giving me an opportunity. I only asked for an opportunity 11 years ago, and I told them I would build them a good program, and never had been in postseason play. And we went 6 out of the last 7, won games in the postseason, got votes in the top 25, and I have 3 of my former players here today, and I want to thank them for being a part of it. They happen to be the 3 leading scorers in Stony Brook basketball history. Brian Dewar, a New Jersey product, one of the all-time greats. Trey Purifoy, Bishop Eustace High School, one of our great guards. And Jameel Warney, one of the great players from Roselle Catholic, and now a guy that the NBA coaches are drooling over. So I'm very proud and thankful that you guys would be here. You guys put me in this position, and I'm proud to have coached you. But those are the kind of kids, all graduates, and all great products of this great state. I need to give a special, you know, mention to the 4 in the front row there. You guys could stand up so everybody could see you, all right? These 4 now, okay. Kevin is my youngest, okay? He's self-proclaimed the most handsome, right, Kev? All right. And Kevin will be our point guard in 2024. And so we're excited about that. And then John is my son there. He'll be 2020 if he works on his left hand a little bit more. And then that's Olivia on the end. Olivia, raise your hand. She's the shy one. And Olivia is my lacrosse star. And I'm honored. And Brooke is my basketball star. She is my oldest. And Coach Stringer, Hall of Fame coach. And I'm very proud that you're here. And I thank you. It's going to be an honor sharing this court with you. And I respect so much what you've done. Brooke can shoot it a little bit, too. So we'll talk afterwards. That won't be a violation now. I work here. So that's a good thing. So I'm honored. I got great kids. I'm sorry my wife wasn't able to make it today. But she will be here, and she'll be the biggest fan of our program and for what we're trying to build. You know, when I thought about this job, I said, you know, how quickly we can turn this thing around if we have the support of our students, if we have the support of our faculty and our staff. It's going to take everybody. It's going to take our president, who, after meeting with him, I was so excited about his commitment to this university and to our athletic program. I couldn't wait to work for him. And then the staff here in athletics have been awesome. Randy, my academic coach, has done an unbelievable job with this team, and she's going to be the assistant coach. She may be the head coach. She's the most important of all. And I look forward to getting a staff in play very shortly. We're going to play a brand of basketball that I think is going to be very exciting. And people often ask me, you know, what is your brand going to be? And I'm going to tell you what our brand is going to be. It's going to be win. Win. We're going to figure out a way to win. Every job I've been at, we've won the league by being the leading scoring team. And then 1 year we won the league by being the best defensive team. I'm going to take the roster that we have. I'm going to add to it. We're going to play with a passion, I promise you. I learned that from my days at UConn, playing for a Hall of Fame coach, Coach Jim Calhoun. I was there day one when he built that program. I have a unique perspective. I was as a player. I lived the build, then I worked for him, and then at the four next stops, worst to first at every stop. And I plan to make Rutgers a terrific basketball program that everyone can be proud of and everyone can take pride in the types of student athletes we recruit and the type of play on the court. I look forward to this challenge. I embrace challenges, and I look forward to great days ahead for our university. I have a little saying here, and I wrote this down, and I thought a lot about this job, and in the last 4 days, my phone hasn't stopped ringing. People congratulating me, people want to work on our staff, but more importantly, I'm meeting Rutgers people, people that believe in this university, and I truly believe in it. I could have stayed at Stony Brook for a long time, but I believe in the people here, I believe in the mission, I believe in the vision, and we will make this a destination for athletes in this state and in other states and worldwide and across the ocean. But I have a little saying, in order to achieve, you must believe. I believe in President Barchi. I believe in Pat Hobbs. I believe in myself, and I have a humbleness, but a confidence that you will see. I believe in Rutgers, and I believe that they gave me a chance, and I don't let people down. I believe we will dance. So I thank you for coming today. I thank you for taking the time. I thank you for listening. I'm excited to get to work. We're going to start tomorrow in the weight room. I'm going to miss my former players, and a lot of them are here today. Some of my teammates from UConn, some former coaches that I work with. Anthony Latina is here, the head coach at Sacred Heart University, and one of my dear friends, Kevin Pappas, his assistant, and my brother Tim here, a couple of my family members, Kirsten Kivy and Jim Duggan, my teammates at UConn. We now have my immediate family of nine, and we have about 30 nieces and nephews. The marketing director is so excited. We just improved season tickets by 50%. So I'm very proud of that. And we now are spreading the good word of this great university up and down the East Coast. I have a tremendous amount of people, too, to thank, because you don't go on this journey alone. I've been mentored by Dave Lato, the head coach at DePaul. He's one of my dear friends. He couldn't make it today because he's recruiting, as he should be. And Howie Dickerman, my mentor at Central Connecticut State, the winningest coach at Central Connecticut State, and my coach at UConn. Jim Calhoun, who I just got off the phone, my mentor, a Hall of Fame coach, has helped me along every stop. When I was at Yale University, Dick Kuchin gave me a chance to coach at a great university and travel the world. I want to thank him. Most importantly, I want to thank you for giving me this opportunity, and I want to thank my wife and tell her that I will see her in about a year and a half, because I certainly have some work to do, and I'm going to embrace it, and we're going to do it the right way, and we're going to make everybody proud of our university. Thank you very, very much.
Now we will begin our Q&A portion. We have Jimmy and Steph with the mics. If you put your hand up, and please identify yourself and direct your question. Sarge.
Hey, Pat. KeithSargeNJ.com. Can you talk a little bit about the process, the search process? There was some speculation that it might not be a desirable job. Was that your view, you know, throughout the process?
Well, my view is it's a great job, that it's an incredibly desirable job. Look, we're a great university. We're part of the Big Ten Conference. And if you can't get excited about going against the Tom Izzos of the world, then you probably shouldn't be in this sport, right? You shouldn't be part of athletics. You know, the process, you know, I think the process was a very, very good one. There was a lot of folks interested in the job. A lot of questions about it, and yes, I mean, some folks look at the job and say that's a difficult job at Rutgers. It's one of the reasons why Steve Pikiell is sitting here today, because he recognizes the challenge, but he has no fear of the challenge. He's been in challenging situations before. And that was important to me through the process, is I wanted somebody who, you know, as he said, would have walked down the New Jersey Turnpike to get the job. So good process. As I said in my remarks, there's just tremendous talent out there in coaching today. That many of them were interested in this job, I think, is a testament to our university and to Dr. Barchi and the vision that he set out. But we ended up sitting here today with absolutely the right person to embrace the challenge and move forward. Bruce?
Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan right here.
Oh,
sorry, Ryan.
Ryan Dunleavy from Gannett. Pat, you talked about that moment that you had when you were sitting across from him. We heard you expand on at Coach Ash's press conference what his vision. What was it from Steve that made you have that moment? Was it the facilities or his staff or academics? What clicked for you?
Maybe there is a pattern starting to emerge here, because I actually think Coach Ash and Coach Pikiell are very similar people. They're both very driven people, but they're very smart people. They've done their homework. They know the institution, they know the conference, they know the challenges, they know our competitors. They bring an intensity and a purpose to everything that they think about, and I think we've seen that, and we're going to see that. I've seen that in 4 days, which I think I'm not sure. The first text has come in at like 4:55, 5:15, 5:10 every morning from Coach. And so that's somebody who embraces the challenge, is out there. I mean, I know he was out last night at the tournament champions game. And I know the coaches and everyone in New Jersey appreciated the fact that Rutgers University was in the gym. So it's that intensity. It's a passion. It's wanting to do it the right way. It's understanding that this is going to take a tremendous effort, but really being ready to embrace that.
Bruce Beck, WNBC TV. Steve, congratulations. How do you do it? How do you win? How do you dance?
That question's been asked at five other stops. You know, I think what's going to happen here, and it's going to happen quickly, we're going to make players better. I think that's very important. We develop the total player. It's not how good you are when you arrive, it's how good you are when you leave. And we're going to hire a great staff. First and foremost, your staff is always the most important thing you do. We're going to take our time with that process and do it right, because once you have your staff, you have your staff. So we're going to be thoughtful about each piece we put together with that. We're going to get to work, you know, with our guys. We started the other day. I think they understand a little bit more about me. I love to win, and I love guys in the gym. We got to change that culture a bit here. But we're going to be very smart about how we attack, you know, the problems and how we solve them. And I'm very excited. I've done this. I've been there as a player. I lived through the transformation. I've done it at four stops. I would have had to do it at five stops, six stops. I told him, I'm going to go somewhere else and do it again. So this is the time. Hire me now, and we're going to do some exciting things. And I know it's not going to be easy. And I told him this too. I embrace that. We play in a great league with great universities. And we're right there with them. And now we're going to build a great basketball program. And it takes time, and it takes patience, and it takes getting a guy like Jameel Warney to get better and to improve, and we can accomplish a lot of great things together.
Justin Walters, Fios One Sports. Pat, you mentioned on Saturday in New York City is when you realized that you had the right man for the job. Steve, where were you when you realized that this was the dream job and you knew you were going to take it, obviously coming off a great season with Stony Brook?
You know, honestly, I've been 25 years running up and down the New Jersey Turnpike in the recruiting process. And I've always looked at this job. Grew up in Connecticut, lived the process at UConn. And my first year at UConn, as Coach Calhoun's first recruiting class, people used to ask, was UConn in Alaska? They knew the UConn Alaska more than they know the University of Connecticut. And so I lived through that transformation. And I looked at this job from afar. I watched the recruiting process. I saw the coaches that they've had in the past, and I've reached out to most of them, and I'm excited, you know, about the alums and about the former coaches, and talked about this great university. And I knew early on when I met Pat that this was a job that I really wanted to embrace and go after. So I'm very excited about, again, his vision. It's all who you work for. Takes a village to raise a program, and I think we have one here.
Coach Mike Pavlichko from WCTC Radio, New Brunswick, here in the back between the cameras. Congratulations and welcome. You've talked a couple times about being up and down the Jersey Turnpike and recruiting over the years at your various stops. A lot of people feel like if half of the top talent every year stayed here at Rutgers, you'd have a tremendous team. How do you go about building those relationships now at an even higher level than the programs that you've been at?
No doubt, you know, you really have to roll up your sleeves. There's great basketball in this area, though. There's great coaches. You have to get in their gyms. You have to do a great job of evaluating, too. I think people are underestimating evaluating players and developing them. And I think what my staff and myself have done a great job of is getting a guy that may be a little under-recruited, and we saw something in him through our work and diligence that other schools didn't, and we made him better. So I'm looking forward to coaches in this area have been awesome, and they have great players, and we'd like to keep them home for sure, and we'd like to develop them and make sure they graduate. It was easy for me to go into New Jersey at Stony Brook because I could say, look at what happened to Jameel Warney. Look at what happened to Trey Purifoy. Brian Dewar played professionally in Australia. They graduated. So I think part of your sell is how well New Jersey players are doing in your program. So we look forward to recruiting this area hard. The coaches will know we're out, and we'll do a great job evaluating, too.
Coach Tara Sullivan from the Bergen Record. You yourself used the word challenge I don't even know how many times today. Mm-hmm. So there's obviously an awareness of what's gone on here, not only on the court, but off the court, not only in basketball, but in football prior to your arrival. So can you just speak to that part of the challenge and how you feel you can sort of overcome what is a very negative perception of what's gone on here the last decade or so?
You know, the great part of that is every job, you know, that I've been a part of, there's been challenges. So there's no job in the country that's perfect. And, you know, this is a university that has a chance to explode. And we're going to do everything in our power to make our basketball program, you know, a respected and proud program. And we have new leadership under Pat and myself, and we're going to get out, and we're going to do things the right way, and success breeds success. And I never look back. I look at the positives. There's so many positives to this job and to this university, and we're going to go after those. And we're going to celebrate those.
Hey, Steve, Adam Zagoria, SMY, congratulations.
Thank you.
I know you reached out to Coach Hurley and Coach Boff and probably some other guys. How much time will you spend, you know, reaching out to other coaches and the high school and AAU guys in the coming days? Will you consider hiring one of those guys on the staff? And is there a place on the staff for Coach Calhoun, or is he just going to be kind of an unofficial mentor?
You know, I'm in the process of, I have over 400 messages I have to return and text messages. You can't imagine the last 4 days from ending our season to what has happened. It's been great. I've talked to as many people as I could in between doing the million things that I have been. We're going to put together a really good staff. I think people are going to be real excited about it. We're obviously going to talk to, you know, all the high school coaches in the area, and have reached out to as many as I could in the last 24 hours and have gotten to a couple games too. So we've done a lot in a short period of time. I have a motto every day, you know, did Rutgers basketball get better today? And it has gotten better for the last 4 days, I promise you. And it'll continue to get better in the upcoming months, my staff. In the next few weeks, we'll be announcing some staff. And I think people will be very excited. Blue collar, guys that work, guys that have great reputations, and guys that want to be here. And I'm excited about, I want kids that want to play here. And I want them to want to play for me, but I want them to want to play for our university.
Steve, hey, Steve Politti from the NJ.com. Did you ask for or receive any assurances about facility improvements, and can you win with the facilities as they are?
You know, I'm so excited about, you know, practice facility. When I saw the renditions of the model, I mean, you know, I'm thrilled. And we're going to pack the rack, and this is going to be a great place to play. I played in the gym and won 3 championships. It was 1,200 seats. They were scalping tickets, because you have to scalp when it's 1,200 seats. And the roof leaked sometimes, and we won 3 championships at Stony Brook. It's the coaches, it's the players, it's the university, it's the people, and we have that combination here, and then some. So I'm looking forward to playing basketball right here in this gym, and we're going to continue to improve facilities, and that'll be great. That'll be a bonus, but we're going to take care of our student athletes and do a great job with them.
Sam Helmina, scout here. Coach, you talked a lot about your players at Stony Brook and how proud you are of them. What do you see from the Rutgers players when you look at them, and what was that first meeting like with the guys?
You know, the first meeting was great. You know, I just laid out some goals and some things that I have that I want them to start accomplishing. You know, I've watched them on tape prior to even interviewing. I saw them play a lot on television, so I know we got a talented bunch. We have to improve. We certainly got to add to our roster, but we have great kids, and I'm very excited about that. Every person here that I've met, from the weight room to the equipment room, has said we have great kids, and I want to recruit great kids. That's how you win. Winning programs are built around great character kids, and so we have that. We got guys that need to improve and get better, and we need to add some pieces, certainly, in a challenging league that we're in with some great coaches, and we'll do that in the next few months and in the next few years.
Steve, Jerry Carino from Gannett, New Jersey. Just to follow up on Adam's question about Coach Calhoun, how will you use him as a resource?
I mean, Coach is the best. If you know Coach Calhoun, he's always got opinions. He's unbelievable. He's won more games than almost anyone. He's been my mentor since day one. I played for him, and then I had the unique responsibility of working with him. So I really, my mentorship under him was invaluable. But he's been there every step of the way. And anytime there's been a difficult situation or advice needed, he's been through it. So it's great to have him. He'll be at our games here, and he'll be coaching the team from the stands. He'll be yelling at the referees, and he'll be yelling at me sometimes too, like when I played for him. So I told him, I don't play for you anymore. You can't yell at me. But he's been truly special, and very thankful to have him in.
Garrett Stepien, the Daily Targum. Coach, this one's for you.
You talked about meeting with the players and, you know, what the potential team could bring next season. What about a guy like Corey Sanders, who's coming off of the freshman year where he was an honorable mention freshman Big Ten?
You know, exciting. I mean, very talented, you know, and they were on spring break, you know, last week. So I haven't gotten a chance to spend as much time. I made phone calls and we talked, and Corey is truly a unique player for us. He needs to get better. Told him that too. I challenged him. You know, he's got to get stronger for his goals that he has set for himself. He needs to improve, and he's going to embrace that. And I'm excited about being able to work with him, and we'll get working in the next few days.
Any more questions? Thank you. We'll do a brief photo op, and then we'll break off into one-on-one sessions. Thank you, everyone.
Nice shot. Thank you very much.